I grab it and I sell it. And now we want to turn this into an advantage for the farmers. They are the ones who are generating data. So they should be the ones who sell their data. And they can say, I'm producing pork and you're getting a folder of data for this piece of pork. This is the theoretical background. This is why we put the farmers into the stakeholder position, the user position, and the data management position. The platform collects a lot of data of feed suppliers, of transportation enterprises, and so on. And behind this concept stands a communication concept, because the more communication there is, the more data flow, the more transparency is given. And the more transparency there is, the better is the pricing in the end. So then all effort for data collection, for investing in more animal welfare, will be back paid in the end. That's the theoretical framework. And this is the joint effort. As you can see, there's many people involved, many steps are involved, and this is what we are working on. This project started 1 year ago, and we will be working on this for another year. The platform is about to be tested by our farmers. And I can say that we try a lot to bring together latest technology to improve the level of communication. We put in our concept. This is just a brief overview over this complicated project. Again, if there's more interest into this, feel free to ask and to contact us, please. Now, coming towards the end of my presentation, here I would like to tell you something about EQA and the University of Champingo, because we already have a kind of joint activities. As I told you already, Professor Maldonado is already a member of EQA, and she helps us, for example, with our website. She's the one who makes it possible that we can offer the EQA website in Spanish as well. So there are updates, there are news, and they don't only come in German and English, but also in Spanish. So if you're interested in what our projects are doing, what's the progress, where do we show up, you may have a look at our website and or also have all information provided in Spanish. This is also true for the description of our project that we have on the website. Knowledge transfer, as I already stated, is something that is part of the work of EQA. And here as well, knowledge transfer is not only done at conferences, but also in materials like books, for example, publications, papers. Here as well, we already work together to get Spanish versions of what has been found out so far. Tune AQA was something I already introduced. You might have recognized Professor Maldonado on the picture, maybe. In this network, we are already connected to each other. Then we have our digital cards. You might have recognized the little picture on the left, on the bottom, on the left side. We are planning to do a 200 days testing. This will be the testing period that I was talking about. And we would be glad if people from Mexico would join, would be interested in joining the testing. And this is something we are planning and developing together, which is starting now. And we have an initiative that is being put up in the past weeks. The title is Back to Life. This is something that we are preparing now. It is about going back to business as usual, whatever that means, after Corona. We need procedures, we need security, we need plans and proceeding, and we can benefit from latest digital developments. So this is an initiative we are planning that you can also take part into. So I want to thank you. And well, now it's time for questions.
Well, thank you very much. Now we are open to questions. So please raise your hand so I can see who wants to participate, please. Could you please turn off your sharing of
Yes, I could. I would just provide you with the information. Sure. If you want to do a screenshot, maybe, then you already have it. But I'm sure that I can send you the presentation afterwards for everyone who is interested. All right, I stop the presentation.
Laura, please go ahead. Please turn on your microphone as well as your camera so we can see who is doing the question. Please, Laura, go ahead. Laura Karen Trejo, please.
Yes, thank you. I have a question, but my English is very bad. And so I write in the chat.
Oh, I can see it. Yeah. All right. Yeah, thank you for your question. And so far as you were talking to us, your English is good. It's very good. So that is no problem. Well, yeah, the standards, that is a huge topic. You're exactly right. There are very different standards in very many countries. And the question always is, which level of standards do we want to have? Right? There are different standard providers. Some have very high requirements, some have lower requirements. Sometimes it's a question about the legal framework in country. So this is quite hard work in some respect to reach same standards. But the advantage of standards is something that can be stressed, and the dialogue and the communication process is very important at that point, right? To share knowledge, to share the experience with certain regulations. And this is a step where we come into discussion and where people of other countries and different standard levels see that more could be done, or where there might be a level of agreement even. And this is, of course, what we are working on and try to reach as many as possible.
Thank you.
No problem. Thank you for your question.
Anyone else? I don't see any hand raised.
Pedro Arriaga wrote another question in the chat.
Okay, Pedro, please go ahead. Turn on your camera, please. Pedro?
Yep, you can see me?
Go ahead.
Well, thanks for your information, Christian. This is very interesting. So here is my question: In many cases, staff working online in retail distribution centers in America Latina does not have access to that information and food safety management. Does the AQA plan to make this type of information available in an accessible form to drive training?
Thank you for your question. Well, yes, of course, this is kind of the strategy, right? If we want to share our knowledge we have to go into such a strategy, to share the knowledge, to provide information. And of course, this is something we are working on in our strategy to where we already have the connection to the University of Shimpingo, right? Because there are already some books that are translated that deal with the topic. And this way we try to reach, of course, other countries, people in the sectors. And one important thing is, of course, we are living in a globalized world. We have a global market, we have international production and supply chains, and we can only reach an agreement upon high standards or a good level of standards if people know about certain things, about latest developments, about requirements. And of course, EQA is active in doing this, yeah.
Well, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Christian, thank you very much for your talk. Now with this problem of coronavirus, one of the difficulties we had was for the students to have practices, you know, to practices for the different courses. And this project that you have in regarding model training, the 3D models, I think it's a solution for at least a great part of the practices that the students need to have. Do you have have you completed some phases of this project right now?
Thank you too for your question. Well, we all have seen that the current corona crisis drives us into solution finding processes that we never have thought of a year ago. So the digitalization, of course, plays an important role in our projects and might even go further in the future. We have some results shown. Do you mean the 3D model of the piglet?
Well, for example.
Yeah. This is something which is available on this company's website that one can see. We also have on the EQA website a section with news, and there should also be some of these findings and developments. There is more to come, of course, because our projects are in the middle of developing, of being tested, and so on. So you will find more results and more material soon. And we try to publish our steps and interesting ideas as soon as possible, as we got them, because you might have seen that our projects consist of very many single ideas that we bring together. EQA is kind of a service provider and a networker at the same time. We bring people together and ideas together, and this way many ideas already exist. Material exists, strategies exist, but the work we do is bring them together and then find those solutions. Yeah, of course, there is already some things are already there, some need to be developed. And yeah, you're updated on our EQA website if you like to.
Thank you very much.
Thank you as well.
Is there any other question, please?
Yes. I have some comments and some questions for Christian. First of all, thank you very much for being with us, Christian, Dr. Petersen, and we have another people from Germany with us. Is Christian Goethe is another lady that is working hard in animal welfare. And there is another people from Germany that I have seen, but I don't know where. Caroline Schuner, thank you. We know that your time zone is different and you're working at night. So thank you very much. And going back to the information that Christian gave to us about concise information about what IQA is doing, objectives and so on, I would like to emphasize the opportunity that has the people that is now with us. We have students, we have people from the enterprises, we have students of us that are working in Uruguay and they are working in food enterprises. And the question is, those people that are interested in training that we have here in Chapingo in our postgraduate program, what are the steps concise to do for getting this kind of training or certification? Can you tell us step by step, more or less, what they must do?
So you're referring to our six fields of specialization?
Correct.
Yeah. Yes. Of course, this was a brief overview I gave. You can have a look at this model on our website as well. Yes, to become a manager or assistant, as these levels are named, the lectures and courses have to be EQA approved. Or you as a lecturer, Professor Maldonado is also an EQA lecturer. So taking courses and classes from her is the first step, is really the first step. And there are some requirements EQA has put up that need to be fulfilled to become, for example, an assistant and an animal health manager, animal health assistant, because you have to know about certain contents, of course. And this is all put up on the website. Right now, I don't have it in my mind, but there's, of course, a lot of content that needs to be taught and that needs to be learned. And when people have taken all classes for this, and the classes have been EQA approved, or the lectures have been EQA approved, they can have a certificate in the end. This would be the procedure for it. Yeah. So thank you for this question. This is an important point. Yeah.
We will continue in contact. We have here people interested on that. So I will do my best to continue with our collaboration. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you as well. Yeah, thank you.
We have some time for another question. Someone? Well, not I will place. It's not really a question, but it's kind of like a thinking that came to me when I was hearing your talk in terms of whatever you're doing, that to me looks like to be an excellent tool, an excellent thing to improve our animal production in terms of welfare and health. But it comes to me that you need to have kind of like a very strong internal market to pay kind of like the overprice to have all these animal welfare and monitoring of the production from the farm all the way to the supermarket, to me means kind of like an overprice that the internal market should be ready to pay for. So I was thinking that maybe in countries like Mexico, where we don't have that strong market, that when people are very reluctant to kind of like overpay for something in terms of saying it's healthier, you know how it was produced, that you know that animals were well treated. I was just wondering, truly to come to this, you truly have to have a very strong internal market. What's experience you have about this?
That's completely right. Yeah, thank you for your thoughts. This is the challenge we have. I guess we are in a global market, we are in a globalized world, but we see all these differences, and they might come from different markets, they might come from a cultural background, they might come from an educational background even, and this is where qualification can do a lot, sharing knowledge and telling people to maybe invest in what they eat so they live healthier, and in the end, living healthy might pay off, because you don't need to go to the doctor as often, you know? So there are several points where education plays a role, the discussion plays a role to bring thoughts and ideas to people. And we also see that this is a problem even in the market. If we have regulations in Germany that are of high level in animal welfare, the supermarket goes and says, well, then we import our pork from Poland, let's say. And we could have regulations as much as we want. If people find other ways, we haven't done anything to improve animal welfare, right? So this is a thing that we need to do jointly, that we need to talk about. And this is the international approach that EQA also has.
Mm-hmm. Well, we have 1 minute left. I don't really take over your time, but this is in the chat version. I will read. It says, as students with the desire to become consultants or auditors in food safety, what will be the courses or the minimum training that students should contemplate during our studies?
Also a good question. Yeah, thank you very much for putting this in the chat. Well, you're already studying, so you learn a lot about food safety, chain management, quality management, and so on. What I try to tell you in this special field slide is an additional training already. At least I can tell from Bonn University that this was an additional training during a study program. So this means you could already specialize in a certain field or even more. And then after finishing your studies, you also could have had certificates about specialization in certain fields. Mm-hmm. And this gives you an advantage on the labor market and to competitors when going for a job. The procedure is something I explained. It's the look for classes that are EQA approved, from lecturers that are EQA approved. And then you can do these steps, take part in these classes, and in the end, get this additional qualification. Mm-hmm. So this is a personal decision, I would say, which one of those specialization fields you choose, because you might also specialize in your work and a profession later. And if you have a clue of where it might go, you, for example, could choose the food safety manager, right? This would be one that would fit perfectly.
Well, we thank really a lot to Christian Kettner. He's
You're very welcome.
He's ready to go to bed, so I don't want to take up your time. Really, thank you for sharing all this information with us, to all our audience. If they want to follow what was said in this session, please go to the electronic portal of the EQES. I think that when I circulate the invitation, I put the address of the EQA. Sorry, it's hard for me to say it. So they can follow. Also, I want to thank all the people that are from abroad, Mexico, and mainly from Germany, as far as I see the, I read the names. So we are really grateful for you having the time to come to our seminar. Here's the website is www.eqase.de and www.eqase.eu. Thanks, Kettner. Thanks for the help. Well, again, we really thank you, all of you. We really thank Christian for his time. We will be sending a little bit of recognition through your email. We will send it right at the end of this seminar. And again, thank you, you all, for your audience. You were an excellent audience. I would like, if possible, for you to turn on your camera so Christian could see that he was talking to people, not only to a machine. So if you have a chance to turn on your camera, please, just for him to know that we were actual people, not only pictures or not only the computer. So please, if you turn your camera and okay, thank you.
That's great. Nice to see the audience. Thank you as well.
See you then. Thank you very much.
Bye bye. Have a good day.
Thank you, Christian.
See you all.
Thank you. Bye.